Hello everybody, Neffertity here. Today we're going to be coming back with the third part in our sculpture tutorial. Last time, we made the basic structure of the body, added the legs and the feet, so today I figured we'd go ahead and do the wings and then start building the head. So let's just go ahead and jump right into it. Alrighty, so the very first thing that we're going to jump into doing is going to be the wings. I always save the head for last, just because it's got a lot of little details in it, and we don't want to risk smashing them or messing them up while we're working on these bigger spots. So go ahead and take some of your clay. Again, I like to mix up a bunch of it so that it's ready to go. And this is that same 50-50 blend of the Super Sculpey gray and the beige. And just like we did for the legs, we're going to tear off a piece about yay big. And go ahead and shape it into that flat teardrop like we did. Oh, sorry about that. And then you're just going to take it, pick which wing you want to start with. I think I'm going to start with this one here. And just press that clay right up against it. It should cover the entire arm of the wing from the shoulder all the way up to the elbow. If you need to put a little bit of extra pieces on, that's perfectly fine. Just got to make sure that you get that little nugget covered. Squeeze it into place here. And you got to be real careful not to mess up your feet or your legs, especially when you're working with the small spots like this, because it's super easy to mess them up. I try to position my thumb about where the chest cavity is, so that way even if I do add too much pressure, it will conform to the chest rather than just smashing the sculpture. And what you're going to do here is just kind of pull this piece until it's real thick at the end, and up here at the elbow you want it to be real thin. So if you need to pull the clay a little further up the arm, you can do that. We're just trying to make it nice and thin. Like that. Looks pretty good. Okay, so once you get that in, you'll notice that you do have some spots back here where it's bare. Don't worry about it. You can go ahead and grab your tool, and I like to use my one with the biggest ball on the end of it. Grab a hold of your sculpture and then just come in here and carefully pull that clay down using the tool. You can see how I'm ever so gently just pulling it in. It doesn't have to go all the way around because we're going to add a little bit more for this little finger right here. We're just trying to get it all nice and smooth together up here. So be sure to come up and blend it into the rest of the wing here so that it all comes together and it makes uniform lines. The reason why we use a tool for this spot is because using your finger to smudge it in, you're going to notice that it tends to pull apart and you get your seams that'll keep coming back. So it's better just to use the tool until you can get it to where they won't come apart again. Smooth out the edges as best you can. We do want it to look like there is a bit of a seam there. So that way it shows that this part connects to the shoulder blade. I'm going to come around here. Try to get this little front piece a bit. There we go. Okay. Once you get that one, now we're going to move on to the fingers, which this part can be a bit tricky because you're working with something so small. The best way I've found to do it is to tear out a piece that's roughly the same length as what you're going to do. So you can see here, this one is about the same length. Try to roll it slightly thick on one end, thinner on the other end. Like that. And then just ever so gently press on it to flatten it out. Pick it up. And then we're just... Oh, this is something I want to mention. Whenever you attach a finger like this, always attach it on the top part of the wing. Never attach it on the bottom, because what you do when it overlaps like this is it's going to create the illusion that there's a knuckle there, and it'll make everything just look so much more organic. So we'll just go ahead, take that, and just like we did with the legs and the tail, wrap it around until both sides meet. Going to get real tricky when you get close to the end. Okay. And now we just have to smooth it out. So just blend the edges together at the top. Go underneath the hand, put those together. Try to avoid tearing it, because too much pressure here, you can very easily tear it. This is a super thin piece. And just slowly work it down to the finger. You can see I'm just ever so gently pulling the clay down. This is a lot easier with larger sculpts, and even with some small ones, you don't even need the wire armature when you do the wings. I make the wings separately and then I'll attach them later. But for this one, I wanted to make sure that they kept their shape without changing it too much. Okay. Now, in Serona's reference sheet, she has little claws at the end of each finger. To do that, all I'm going to do is just pull the clay so that it's nice and loose at the end of the finger here. You can kind of see that. There's like a little ball at the end. Take your tool and just gently make a small divot in the end of it. We're going to plug a claw in there a little bit later, but we'll get into that in the next tutorial. Okay. And then you're just going to repeat this process with all the other fingers, rolling out the pieces, attaching them on the top, bringing them all the way down. Do it with however many fingers there are, and then remember to repeat with the other wings so that they are symmetrical. I'm going to go ahead and do that, and then I will see you guys in just a minute once I finish that. Alrighty. So, once you finish completely coating the wings with the clay, you can see that they're nice and they match everything else. Now, we are going to... Yeah, let's go ahead and do the head first. Oh, always be sure that once you finish coating a piece you make sure that it still fits. Which it does, so we're good. Just gotta bend the legs a little. Okay. Alrighty, so to do the head, you wanna get a solid piece of clay. Try to measure it out about the size you want the head. I think this is actually the perfect size, which works out great. So the first thing I'm gonna do is roll a little ball. And then I'm going to tear two little nuggets out of it. And make sure that they're about the same size. It's about the same. Okay. Make this back into a ball again. Okay, and now we're going to start forming the actual head. So, you're going to take one end of the clay ball and pull on it like this. So you can kind of see the shape that we're making here. You want it to be more spherical at one end and more almost rectangular at the other. See? Just like that. Okay. Now, I'm going to take my X-Acto. Because I want her tongue to kind of loll out of her mouth like she's drunk since she's going to be sitting in a sake dish. So in order to do that, I have to cut the mouth. And the first thing I always start with when I do a mouth is almost like a little cat-lipped face. Because of the way most animals have their lips, this is the way I draw my dragon mouths. They have this little cat lip at the end of their face. And then from there, I'm going to make cuts that go to the same length on either side. Once you get those, just carefully come in with your X-Acto and press so that the cut goes all the way through the clay. See? That's the start of our little old mouth. Now, if this is your first time sculpting, using an open mouth design can be a bit daunting, but after some practice, I'm sure you'll get great at doing it. It's just a matter of keeping up with your practice and, you know, trying new things and new ways, new poses. Lots of different ways that you could do it. Right now I'm just kind of smoothing out the edges from that rough cut that I made. I'm going to come in here with my tool. I'm going to try to show you guys this as best I can. But I'm just making a slight groove on the inside of the mouth here. Because what this is going to turn into is it's going to be the gum line for when I put in some teeth. Got to do both the top and the bottom. Okay. I want to bring the corners of the mouth up a little bit, so I'm actually going to get my nice thin tool here. I'm going to stick it right in the end and just slightly turn it up. So you can see what that did. Made a nice little score mark in there that kind of looks like a smile. Do it to the other side so that they match. Looking good. Okay. If you've messed up your clay a little bit, this is where you want to come through and just try to even it out a little bit. There we go. Looks good. Okay. Now we're going to do the eyes. So in order to do those, grab your tool that has the biggest ball end on it. And you have to find the center line of the face, which, if you know what center lines are, it's that little crosshair that goes over any face when an artist is doing a drawing or just trying to find the center of something. So in this, you want to look directly at it and figure out where the center of the face is. And from there, go back and make little symmetrical marks on either side. They don't have to be real heavy, just real nice and light. You can see they're on both sides. Make sure it looks symmetrical when you're staring at it from all sides. Okay. Once you get that, very carefully with your tool, come in here. And you're going to make a nice round hole in the clay. Gotta be real careful with the mouth because you don't want to mess it up. And we're gonna make these little holes right here. These are gonna be our eye sockets. And that is where these come in. Grab one of them and tear off a piece that should be about the size of the eyeball. Make it nice and round. And then you simply just take it, stick it in the hole, and then look at it. If it pops out too much like this, then you know you have to take away a little bit of clay. Because we don't want them to be bug eyes, we just want these little eyes. So put that one in. I like that much better. Okay, just make sure that it's in there and it sits fairly flush, and then do the same thing to the other side. Just like that. So now you can see that our eyes are on and they're nice and symmetrical, but we're not quite done yet. You're going to tear off two relatively thin pieces. I think the easiest way to do this is going to be to roll these little balls that we had out into thin noodles. We're trying to use them both rather than just using one because we want them to remain symmetrical. So as you can see, one of them is clearly longer than the other one, so they're not equal. But that's okay. We can work with that. All right. Measure them out. Right about there. Now those two are even again. And this you want to cut into four equal pieces. So we'll cut it in half, and then cut each half in half. Sorry about that. So now we have our four equal pieces. Gonna take one of them, and ever so carefully, place it over the top portion of the eye, like that. Just gently push it into place with your fingers. Let's see if I can hold it so you guys can see it. Just like that. And then do the same thing with one of the other ones, except this time we're going to put it along the bottom piece, making sure that the ends connect. I'll show you what I mean about that in just a second. Like that, see? And now using a small ball tool, you're going to very carefully blend in the top and bottom pieces. Come in with your larger tool to smooth out all the individual lines. You can already see what that's starting to do. We're making eyelids. This is a neat little method that I learned probably 4 or 5 years ago, I think. I remember trying to figure out why my eyes looked so goofy on my sculptures, and it was because I used to just paint them on. And I remember looking at somebody's work. I think it was emilySculpts. She's an absolutely astonishing sculptor, and she does such beautiful work. And I noticed that a lot of her work in progress, she had these little lumps of clay on them around the eyes. And I did some research on it and found out that it's eyelids that she was building. And I added them to my sculptures, and immediately they just look 10 times better. There, see? Isn't that cute? Got a nice little eyeball. If you feel like one of them is a little too strong, you can always pull down the clay a little bit, which is what I'm going to do with the bottom eye here, because I don't want it to look super intense. But I do want her eyelids to be raised a little bit, since she's supposed to be drunk. There. Beautiful. And then just go ahead and repeat this process with the other side. So once you go ahead and you get both eyes done like that, now we're going to add the eyebrows. And since this is a smaller sculpture, I want it to kind of have like a cute-esque look to it. So what I'm going to do here is, first I'm going to roll these back into little balls because I need them to be thicker. Okay. And I think half of this one should be perfect. So I'm just going to take it, tear it in half, and then make 2 little teardrop shapes. Just like that. We're going to take one, curl it just barely over your thumb like that, and place it right on top here. Now this is how I do emotions with my characters and my sculptures, is I use the eyebrows. So for this one, I'm going to place it right above her eyebrow where it would go. Just squeeze it into place like this. So you can kind of see how that looks. And then for the other one, since I want her to be drunk, I'm kind of going to give a little bit of a different effect. So since this one is sitting up like that, I want this one to kind of lull down to the side a little, make it look like her eyes half closed. See? Now you just take your tool, and similar to what we did with the eyelids, just smooth in the edges, but don't smooth them in when they overlap the eyelid. Just leave that one as it is, because we want that little crease to be there. So what I'm going to do is just come around here like this. Smooth all that in. If you get little pieces that kind of go where they're not supposed to, that's the good thing about using a thin tool like this one, is I can just stick the end of it in there and I can fix that. It's a lot easier on larger sculptures because you're not working with something this tiny. But it is a fun challenge to try to do a small one like this. Okay, once I get those eyebrows all smoothed in on the edges and attached, I'm just going to come in here with my thumb and just kind of soften those edges a bit so that they're not so raspy like this one here. It's kind of hard to see it with my camera that won't focus, but you can see there's all those rasp lines right there from where I blended the two together. You just have to gently go over them with your finger, and it should fix it. Another little neat trick you can do to get rid of rasping lines like that is you can have rubbing alcohol and put just a little itty bit of it on a Q-tip and rub it through the edges here, and the rubbing alcohol will eat away the clay and it will take the texture with it. So it's real good for removing those unwanted lines and unwanted textures that you might have. But it is important to keep in mind that it is an alcohol that is going to eat clay. So the more you use it, the more of your clay is going to get eroded, so you do have to be real careful that you don't end up destroying your sculpture. I've done that one more than once, and it's real depressing when you realize that there is no going back. Okay. So there we go. Now we have the rough start of our little face. I'm going to make some teeth and a little tongue. So first I'll make the tongue. Try to measure out a piece that should be about the length of the mouth. You can always make it thinner or thicker depending on what you need. And since tongues aren't real thick, I do want to kind of smooth it out a little bit, make it a bit flatter. And Serona has like a little fork at the end of her tongue. So I'm going to come in here and just cut away some of that so I can make that little fork. If you want, you can add a little texture line in the center, or if your character has like a cat's tongue where they have all the rough spots on it, you can always poke a toothpick in it to make those little bumps. There's all kinds of cool things that you can do with it. Add another little texture detail on the bottom here. It may not show, but I just like to be prepared. Okay. So there we have a little tongue. I'm going to take it, mold it as needed be. Let me see. Maybe if I go just right down the front. Yeah, I like that. That's cute. Okay. So once you decide where you want it to go, press it into place using a real thin tool. And there's kind of a trick to doing this. You get better with practice, but you want to make sure that right at the back of the throat, I don't know if you can see in there, it goes down a lot deeper as it gets to the back of the throat, and then you kind of use your tool to erode out a little hole at the back, and that'll kind of simulate a throat. It's a neat little detail that you can do. It's much more evident in larger sculptures, but for this small one, I think it'll be fine. Okay. Now, we get to do the teeth. Alright, so I went ahead and scrapped the teeth idea. It looked a little bit too aggressive when I tried it. So what I'm going to do is fix this eyeball. You notice sometimes that when you're working with your clay, you're going to get pieces that will go where they're not supposed to. You can fix that real easy just using the end of a sharp tool. Okay. Now, since I don't want it to look super aggressive, I think what I'm going to do is, with that tongue lolling out now, I'm just going to lightly close the mouth around it. So that it looks like the tongue is just barely sticking out. Trying to keep the snout intact here as I'm working. There we go. That looks cute. Much better. With that done, we're going to go ahead and make our nostrils, which are real easy. Just take the small end of a ball tool and drag them through the front of the clay a little bit. Just like that. Real easy. Gonna make the loaf lines on the face. Okay. Looks pretty good. I'm happy with that. You can etch in some details on the underside of the chin if you'd like. And when you're happy with how your face looks, now it comes time to do the tricky thing, which is going to be attaching it to the head. The easiest way I can describe to do this is to take your ball tool, the one with the big end, and just press it at the back of the head. And just move it around and around and around in a circle until you get a nice big cavity like that. Oh, there we go. Okay. Alrighty. So once you get that nice big cavity, this is where you're going to come in here and just slip it right on. You can see how that's going to go on there. Using your fingers, pinch the edges closed around it. So now the head's attached. Now we have to build it out to make it not look like such a noodle neck. Okay. Go ahead and take your clay. This one's a little bit stiff. There we go. Just tear out a piece. It's about the size of a small gumball.
and you're going to flatten it out. See how thick that is. It's fairly thick. Make a little divot at the top of it right there. And this is the piece that we are going to plug. Yeah, let's go ahead and plug this one on top of the head. That seems to be where we need more meat. Always be sure that you kind of measure it out where it's going to go and make sure that you're happy with how it's going to look. And then just pinch it all into place. Now here's where you kind of have to eyeball it and look at the thickness. See if that's what you want. If you feel like you need a little bit more to certain places, tear off your piece of clay. And go ahead and add it in there. I think it needs just a little bit right here at the chest. It's got to go up a little higher. All right, I'm happy with that. So this part is going to take a little bit, but what you're going to have to do is completely blend these edges into everything without messing up the face or the legs or anything else. This is why I said it can be really difficult to do this when you're working with smaller sculptures. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and I will see you guys in a minute. Alrighty, so once you get the head attached and it's all smoothed out, you've fixed any details that may have gotten, you know, smashed off of the face while you were working on it. Lay it down in your container or whatever you're using, if anything. Make sure it all still fits back in its position. If you need to move it around a little bit, this is the time to do it. Just kind of fix it however you want it to go. And then we are going to need a new little machine. You can do this with a rolling pin, but I prefer to use this beautiful thing. It's two pieces. It's got, you know, the wheels up here. You've got your dial setting. Oops, sorry about that. You got your dials on the sides here. And the little crank below. What this thing is it's a pasta machine. When I was in college, I had a friend who worked with polymer clays, and she told me about using pasta machines in order to roll out your clay. I'd never heard of such a thing. She gave me one, and it has been just a phenomenal change. It's made my life so much easier to have it. I'm so happy that I have this. So if you do have one, go ahead and put it onto setting... let's go setting 3. Put your crank in the side here. There should be a little notch for it to line up with. There it is. Okay. And then you're going to take the Super Sculpey itself, just this beige one. Kind of roll it into a little bit of a cylinder. Place it in the top. You can use your hand to push it through. And then just turn the wheel. I'm going to try to do this so that I can still turn it and you guys can see it going. Force it through. You can see it coming out the bottom there. There it goes. So just turn that crank till all the clay goes through. I like to run it through again to get out any air bubbles that may have gotten caught. Okay. Now, like I said, you can do this with a rolling pin. I like to use my pasta machine just because it makes it so much easier and you get one uniform thickness. So you can see that is super, super thin, which is exactly what we want. You want to make sure you have like a big piece. It'll make it real easy when you go to do this. Let me get this one. Take your ball tool that has the smallest point or anything, even a toothpick, just something so that you have control for what you're doing. Grab your sculpture. And we are going to measure by placing it on there. And just trace along the inside of the wing. Just like that. Do the same thing with all the other membranes. Now, if you're having to do feathered wings and you'd like to learn how to do that, I'd be more than happy to make a tutorial to teach you guys how. All you have to do is just ask and I would be very glad to help you. So if that is something that you're interested in doing, let me know. Get that one. And then when you get to that last piece of the body, that's a tricky one. Just like that. I'm gonna measure out a small sail. Okay, so there's one wing. Now we gotta do the other one. For certain sculptures, when I'm doing the wings like this, I just drape the clay over it and cut off the excess. But since Serona's wings are a little interesting, and she has different colors on the ventral versus the dorsal, I do want to make sure that I get it right. Here we go. That looks about right. So we'll put her back over there for now. And now you can kind of see there is these little wing-like patterns that I've etched in here. We're going to cut those out. So just grab a hold of your X-Acto and go in here and cut them. Alright, so once you get those all cut out, you're going to just carefully peel away the clay. Try to keep them in their same pattern as you're peeling it. It'll make it easier for when you're trying to figure out which piece goes where. Okay. And I am going to cut this excess here. Crumple that up into a little ball to put it away. I am going to keep this one though, because I'm going to use it for something else. So I'll just put it up over there. Alrighty, so once you get your pieces all cut out, you get to come in with the wing. Just go ahead and grab the first one. And it's real easy. You just insert it right along the inside. Make sure you pull it so that it stays. Do the same thing to the other half. And when you're pressing the edges in, make sure that you do so from the inside of the wing. It'll create a really nice looking effect. It'll make it look more realistic, in my opinion. Okay. So just keep on coming down here. Smoothing in the wing. I'll show you guys. if I can angle it, there we go. So you can see I've just kind of pressed that little membrane in there. Go ahead and do the same to all the other sides. When you get to this last digit here that's going to connect directly to the body, you want to kind of layer it a little more on the top than you did with the other ones, whereas it was just on the inside. And this membrane should connect between the thigh here and at the top of the elbow of the wing. So just go ahead and press these pieces together. Make sure that you get a nice tight seam on the edges. If you get a little piece that kind of comes over there, just barely blend it in, because we do want to see these real fine edges here. They're going to make all the difference in the end and make it look like these two pieces are supposed to be separate. And then just take that little sail that you made, layer that one on top. Press all those little pieces in. And there you go, just like that. You can see how smooth and fine all those edges are. They just really blend together and they make it look more natural. We have one more detail that we're going to do to the wings, but we're going to wait until we do the other one. So I'm going to go ahead and do this wing, and I will see you guys in just a minute. Okie dokie. So once you go ahead and you get both wings done and they've got their membranes in them, there is one more detail that we're going to add, and this is where you need a toothpick or a real teeny tiny tip on the end of a ball tool. Lay the wing as flat as you can without messing with the pose too much. And what we're going to do is kind of score some little veins in there. So just take your tool and just kind of lightly make these little etchings. They should kind of go in almost like a lightning pattern, to where they are very smooth lines, but they bend and they twist, and there's, you know, there's little edges that kind of fold over each other. Just real lightly. This is a detail that adds just a little bit more depth to a sculpture. Makes it look more organic, especially when you're doing a large one and you can see these details pop. And you'll be able to see them a lot more once we start adding paint to this. But we're just trying to get these small little details in here. I'll show you guys in a minute here what I'm doing. Okay. And you totally can't see that at all. Beautiful camera quality. Well, let's see if I can describe it on this. So essentially what I'm doing is I'm taking my tool and I'm making little squiggles like this. So it's something kind of like that. Little vein structures, and they're just all over the interiors of the wings, but they're super light. You would just barely be able to see them. It's a little detail that just makes the whole wing look a little bit more natural. I'm going to do it to this other side here. I'm just going to make all these little markings. Flip them over. And on the dorsals, we're not going to do the vein structure, but rather we're just going to do a couple little lines. You can kind of see the motion that I'm doing. Just barely dragging the tool over the top here. Since the dorsal would be the tough and shiny side of the wing, we're just gonna make a couple of these little markings on here, and it'll make the whole thing pop once we go to add paint and color to it. Underside gets veins, top side gets little etchings. There. Just like that. Make sure you kind of bend the membranes so that they're more arced on one side than they are versus the underside. Just adds a realistic little bend to their detail. Here we go. Just like that. Okay. Remember to take your dish or whatever you're using to pose your sculpture and be sure that it sits in it like it's supposed to. If you need to move it around at all, this is the time to do it. Okay, looks good. Alrighty.
So, in this tutorial, we learned how to do the wings, and we built the face, we've got membranes on there, we've attached the head. Our sculpture's almost ready to enter the detailing phase, which is what I'm going to show you guys how to do in the next tutorial. So, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video or felt you learned something, please be sure to leave a like and do subscribe to my channel. I would so much appreciate it. If you have any ideas for something you'd like to see done or just a couple questions, feel free to comment below. I'm always answering questions. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day and a wonderful life.